Sparkman. Sparkman's got the best theme music of any Mega Man. It's just complete awesome. And there's a B1. Apparently I'm in the basement of this crazy power plant or something. I don't know where the fuck I am. Now I'm on the first floor. Which is good, because Mega Man never had any maps. I could totally use a map to figure out where to go. Oh wait, I just have to keep going right. Never mind. Pull out the snake. Alright, suck. You know, the snake is a pretty awesome weapon, but considering how it doesn't work on most of the enemies in the game, it just bounces off, it's actually pretty shitty. So, if I were Snake Man, I'd be ashamed, just based on that evidence. I fucking hate these things. They're timed in just a way that I can't figure out how to get past them without getting hit in the face. What is up with these guys with the eyes? And just eyes with feet attached to them? I don't need to get to populate these fucking, you know, levels with all these bosses and all these enemies, but you gotta put a little bit of effort into it. I mean, they don't have a reason to exist. They don't have any practical or military uses. They're just walking around waiting to die. And their weak spot is a giant eye on the front of their head. So, I don't know. This is actually kind of a tricky part, considering how fast this thing plunges up, and you got all these fucking screws to worry about. Now, there's another one, I'm trying to trigger it, but I can't. There it goes. If you're not confident about your jump, just let the guy hit you in the face. And then you wait for the next guy. And the next guy comes up, and you let him hit you in the face until you're invincible, and you can get confident in your jump. You can't do it all day, because you'll eventually run out of life, or you might get knocked off the platform. But you'll get it. You have no reason to exist. Fuck you. So now I'm gonna go to the boss. And the boss isn't gonna be that hard, he's pretty easy. Pot of Shadow Blades. He's kind of weird. He just kind of jumps around like a crazy psychopath, throwing big-ass lasers. But if you did notice, I was like just fucking wailing on him with the Shadow Blades, but he wasn't taking damage instantly like all the Mega Man 2 bosses. So this is where they started to make a conscious effort that, hey, Mega Man's too easy. You just sit there wailing a guy with rapid-fire weapons, and he'll just keep taking damage, he'll be dead in like a second. So they said, okay, we'll fucking fix that. We'll turn that shit off, we'll add a delay, just like Mega Man has. Because Mega Man, that's his best ability. And you could run, you could jump, you could shoot, you could dash. Fuck that. His best ability is temporary invincibility whenever he gets hit. That's the best weapon. And kind of carries over. You see it in a lot of games, and it makes sense. But hey, you know, why can't we give it to the bosses? The bosses are way too easy that way. Here's another fight with fucking Proto Man. Never changing his strategy. Which is kind of lame that, like, he's essentially kind of like an occasional mini boss that appears like 4 times. I think it's only 3 times, but you know, he never changes his style, and there's only one place where it's marginally more difficult, so I don't know. There's plenty of cool enemies anyway, so it's not like you're missing out. And this game is way longer than the other ones too. Like, you can compare the length of this game to Mega Man 2, it's almost twice as long. Like, seriously, I'm not even exaggerating. And then, you compare it to all the other Mega Mans after this one, and it's just about as long as any other Mega Man that comes after. And you'll see why in just a little bit. This is everyone's favorite part of all Mega Mans, where there's the fucking blocks with the obnoxious doop sound effect. And you fucking messed up once, you're fucking dead. Happens in every Mega Man game. And what do? We always just pull out our rush weapon and get the fuck out of there. Yeah, my boss. So now I'm getting up on the enemy, and I have full life, so I don't need to kill myself like an idiot. I mean, this stage is kind of hard because of that, like the block puzzle and all the enemies, but you can totally wipe them out pretty easy, so it's easier than most bosses or enemy or levels. Yeah. Did you fucking see that? Like, he hit me once and I was like halfway dead. It's badass. Which is the thing, if you're playing these games, and you're thinking, hey, I'm getting my ass kicked, I need to figure out a strategy to combat this. Just remember that if a boss hits you with a projectile, it'll probably do way less damage than if they hit you with their body. Just keep that in mind. And in like 90% of cases, that's true. So like, you'll get hit by the guy by like a bullet, and it'll be like 2 or 3 lines taken away, but if he touches you, it's like 5 or 10 lines away, and you'll be dead in 3 hits. I don't know why that is, but these fucking bees piss me off. They're like the worst boss, the worst enemy in all Mega Man games, because you can't stop them from doing what they're doing unless you're flying up there. And even if you're flying up there, you still might not be able to get it, because their cocoons are invincible. So I don't know. You only have to meet them one other time. And that's that stage is pretty short. It's like 3 fucking screens long. It's not even really a stage. It's just a segue. So I'm on my way to Hard Man, who is the most sexually ambiguous character of all Mega Man characters. I love these monkey enemies. They're one of my favorite enemies, in that I hate them, because if you get too close to them, they will jump down and run at you like a fucking psychopath. They'll be jumping around real fast. They're virtually impossible to kill because they're just too fast. So you don't want that to happen. You just want to kill them from like 10 feet away while they're complacent. Toss them a banana, just pass by. And once again, we come to another little puzzle that says, hey, remember, you have a slide attack. You should use it, because it's the best attack you can ever have. Which I was kind of bummed, where when they finally made Mega Man 9, they came out and they said, hey, we're gonna go back to basics. We're gonna continue off of Mega Man 2, and we're gonna take out everything that we implemented in Mega Man 3 onward, and just start from scratch. So they took out the dash attack, and they took out the charge buster. And here's another Proto Man. This is actually a difficult Proto Man match, because there's like tiers, so you actually have to dodge his bullets rather than just stand there like an idiot. Don't let him touch you, because you do way more damage. We've been through this. But yeah, like, in later Mega Mans, I don't really miss the fact that they took out the Charge Buster, because that was overpowered piece of shit anyway. They said to make all the enemies way harder, or at least way tougher, just to compensate for the fact that it was overpowered and broke everything. But the slide attack was the best attack. Here's Erection Man. He's throwing his rock-hard fists at me, and just dive-bombing like an ostrich into the ground. Which, that has to be weird programming. You know, your defensive repertoire consists of throwing your rock-hard knuckles across the screen, and then dive-bombing head-first into the ground, hoping you hit an enemy. I'm gonna crush you with my face. I got the hardest knuckle. No knuckles are harder than mine. So now you're like, what the fuck? I destroyed everything. But there's these weird ass guys. Question mark man. He's the most mysterious of all mans. So now I'm back on this level with the awesome theme music. Another completely defenseless iRobot. And right off the bat, you notice this level is way different. I was like, oh, well, they just made the game harder. Like, it's not a different level, they just made it harder. Like, no, watch this shit. This is a completely different level now. You're going through all different stages, and it's all completely different. It's crazy. And this is why this game is so fucking awesome, and why it's so fucking long. Because after you do this, you're like, well, okay, what happens after you do all this? And you're like, guess what? We're still only halfway done, fucker. You gotta go fight Wily. And he's got a brand new castle that he got with grant money. So, you remember none of this shit existed in any other levels so far. All this is completely new. And you're like, holy fuck. And it's like way harder than it was in the first go-around. So it's... basically, it just shares the same theme as the original levels did, but nothing else. And this is where, if you don't know this game, this is where you fucking lose your shit. Because you're like, who is this boss gonna be? And you're like, wait, I know that guy. That's fucking Metal Man. Are you telling me that I have to fight all of Mega Man 2 bosses over again? This is Mega Man 3. I thought those were like new bosses. Like, no. You get to fight all the old bosses again. How crazy is that shit? And not just that, you gotta fight two bosses in one level. Fucking two. Which is, you know, a mechanic that they'll bring up later on in other Mega Man games, where you fight multiple bosses in the same level. And you just gotta keep on trucking. I hate these things. The gears not so much. Actually kind of remind me like a Mega, a Mario, where like you were on the fortress, the flying fortresses, and you would have to jump on the thing to make it go across, and it would screw in and then it would stop moving. They're like that, but they've come to life to haunt my dreams. Apparently, in this electric factory that Sparkman calls a home, there's all these trash compactors putting out, I guess, dirt and debris. I don't know. What kind of factory is this? There shouldn't be industrial waste of that magnitude. So now, I have to fight Quick Man, who's one of the hardest bosses of Mega Man 2. But I have to use the fucking slowest ass weapon of all Mega Man 3 weapons to fight him with. And he's not just fast, he's like 10 times bigger than he was before. So good luck dodging that asshole. Yeah, I did it. I beat the levels. Now level 2. Another question mark, man. Which I don't remember what the name of this robot's supposed to be. Some kind of doctor, dark doctor, doctor master, dark, not something, I don't know. Basically, there's a lot of copies of it. He's like a Cylon. And each one has a different robot in it. And he's just there to ruin your shit. Now this is probably my least favorite of all the revisit stages, because you noticed in the last one I had to use the rush coil just to beat the level. And that's fine, that's okay, I gotta use it here too. But this level, after you beat a hard ass boss, which they give you like no health items afterwards by the way, so you just have to kind of just tough it out or kill yourself. you have to use the jet to get across the entire level. And if you fuck up, then that's it. That's pretty much game over. You gotta go back and try it all over again, because you can't find enough power-up items to recharge your shit. Take another E-tank that I probably won't even use. I don't even think I've used any in this game. I think I'll use like maybe one or two towards the end, and then that'll be it. Don't use them very much. Most bosses are pretty easy. So now I pull out the sparks, so I'm gonna fight another awesome Mega Man 2 boss. Who's it gonna be? Airman. The most emo of all Mega Man bosses. We've been through this. Look at this shit. How much damage he does. He's not as much of a pushover as he was before, because it took like 10 hits to kill him. Remember from Mega Man 2, it took two bunches of leaves to kill that motherfucker. But now in this game, it takes like 10 sparks. So I did that, because I didn't have any more life left. And I'm gonna fuck up. Ruin my life. Let's just try this on a fresh start. And all these paratroopers are back. And they're there to just to fuck with you. That's all they're there for. Oh, and by the way, if you're doing this, don't ever pause the game while you're in the air, because Rush will disappear and you will fall to your death and have to do the whole level again. Just putting that out there. And they conveniently, okay, see what I'm talking about? They're gone. Now to bring it back. And now I've glitched the game, and now I'm gonna flash for the rest of eternity, apparently. Or until I pull the trigger, I guess. Which I thought was a nice addition here, where they gave you the ability to use the regular Buster when you're using the rush attacks. It's kind of designed for that, because like they have all these enemies everywhere, and they're like, well, you can just try to avoid them, or you can fight them. Kind of adds another little layer of death that wasn't there before. You couldn't do that with the first level with Mega Man 2 items. You know what I'm saying? So this is a rough jump right here. So even with the coil, like, you barely make it. And if you fuck up, you're probably dead. You have to do the whole level again. And there'll be no energy recharges. So here's a little backtracking. You remember last time I was in Needle Man stage, you saw like the tops of these guys' heads? They were inside of giant platforms. Yeah, they were totally just sitting there dormant the entire time. Just chilling out. And I'm gonna try to kill this guy, but he's fucking being a punk bitch. He won't let me shoot him. There's gotta be an easier way to do this. Let's try this. Fucking stop doing that. Asshole. Alright. I don't know if that worked or not, but made me feel better. Oh, it's a new guy. He's raining down death from the sky. This is just another day and night in Needle Man stage. I always love the weird sound effect that those cannons make. They're like, boo, boo. Which are, they're supposed to be shooting cannonballs or something. Cannons don't make that sound. Yeah, that's effective. Took like 3 or 4 hits. Which basically, I love the Shadow Man's blade, because it's basically like the Metal Man attack from Mega Man 2, except it's been nerfed considerably, so it's not overpowered. Which is fine. I mean, it made Mega Man 2 boring that it was so overpowered. So now I'm gonna fight fucking Crash Man. And I have to beat him with literally the worst weapon, because you can barely control it. And he's fucking running around like an idiot. So you kinda have to be right in his face and let him punch you before you can punch him. Just gotta hope that your punch is harder.